Hey everybody, today we are going to go through how you change your coolant on your 1000SX. Now I need to put a disclaimer out there. Unfortunately, I cannot get most of the parts for a coolant change. That's some of the hoses, the gaskets, and you want to change your cooling system fluid, your hoses, your gaskets, your O-rings, thermostat, and radiator cap every 3 years or 36,000 kilometers, which would be about 22,800 miles. But since I cannot get most of the parts, they're back ordered. And the reason why this video is so late is because I wanted to get it out earlier for you guys. But the reason it's so late is because I've been waiting for the back ordered parts for a couple months now. Still have not gotten them. I've tried RevZilla, PartZilla, Amazon, local dealerships, everything. I cannot get the parts. So this is a coolant change, which is the most important part for the 3 year timeline. And that's because the lubricative properties of engine coolant break down over time, just like oil. So those break down and then usage. So the longer it's used, the more it breaks down. So you need to change at least at your minimum is the coolant. So that is what we are going to do today. And Kawasaki may be a little overcautious. Even so, make sure to check all your hoses. Make sure there are no rips, tears, cracks, anything. In which case you're going to have to try and find the parts. I do recommend, because of the back ordered problem, unless maybe in Europe you can get them quicker, I don't know, but over in the US I recommend ordering now just so you have them, because if a hose goes, it's going to be really hard to get. Now you could go and custom fabricate them, that's true. I do recommend ordering now. Full coolant system change is about $300 US if you go through all the hoses and thermostat and all that. But again, we are just doing the coolant today. Okay, so to change the coolant, you're going to need at least 2.9 US quarts or 2.7 liters of coolant. It's better to have extra, so go ahead and just get a gallon. For the antifreeze, you will want to get either the 50-50 mixture, or if you get concentrate, you will need distilled water. A note about the distilled water, you need to use distilled water. Do not use tap water. Tap water contains minerals that will damage your cooling system. Please use distilled water. You will need a 8mm socket and socket wrench. You will also need a M6 or 6mm crush washer. Please change the crush washer. A lot of people end up reusing them, but that's how they end up having leaks form. Life will be a lot easier if you have a fluid transfer pump, and that's to get the coolant out of the reservoir and also pump new stuff into the radiator. But if you don't, that's fine. You will need a torque wrench. You'll want a drain pan or some way to catch the antifreeze. Probably want some shop towels or paper towels in case you make a mess. You will also need all the tools to remove your lower fairings. All the parts I have listed below, including for a full coolant change, including hoses and everything, I have all the parts listed below, but again, this video is just a coolant change. I'm sorry I can't go into the rest, but I need the parts before I rip some of that stuff out because they are one-time use. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so we already removed the middle fairing, side cover, lower fairing, seat, etc. All right, the first step is to go to the right-hand side of your bike, near the front of the tank or air intake area, you will find the radiator cap. To remove the radiator cap, just turn left and push down and turn the remainder of the way, and then it pops off. You need to remove the radiator cap to make it the system actually drain. There is not a vacuum or any kind of resistance. It makes it easier to drain the fluid out. So once you have the radiator cap off, we need to move to the other side of the bike. Okay, we are on the left-hand side of the motorcycle right now. And if you follow your gear shift up, you're gonna find this bolt right here. This is your drain bolt. It uses an 8mm socket. So first thing I'm gonna do is put a drain pan underneath. So I got a drain pan underneath. I'm actually gonna move my kickstand out of the way. I do have the motorcycle on paddock stands just to give more clearance. And I'm gonna zoom in here. So it's just this bolt. ahead and pop it. Should not be on that cuff. And get ready to move the pan, depending on how fast the fluid comes out. Oh. It shoots out quite far. I've got coolant everywhere right now. You guys know I'm pretty transparent when things go wrong. So the coolant, it shot out about 4 feet, sprayed everywhere. My hands are covered. I don't want to touch the camera, but once I can, I'll show you the mess. So right now I am basically holding the pan up. I don't know if I can get it in frame to try and catch it all. Once it dies down, you can set the pan down. Coolant isn't too bad to clean up, but you want to make sure no cats or anything get it. And then as it gets low, it's going to start feeding into this and kind of going everywhere. So best thing to clean up with is actually a mixture of Dawn or dish detergent and water, which we will do once this is fully drained. So I'm going to let this sit here a minute. Let me take my glove off and then I'll show you what happened here. So as you can see, it came out. So as you can see, it came out a good ways. So be prepared for that. And just let it drain completely. And we will come back. Okay, so it's still dripping, but that's okay. Get as much out as you want, as we can. That's fine. While it's dripping, we're going to drain the reservoir. Now, you can go and drain this the manual way, which would be, there's two bolts. There's 8 millimeter. There's one in the back, and there's one you're not going to be able to see, which is in the front. They have thread locker on them, so they are tough to get started. But you'll take those out. You have to remove this hose. Now, you should try to get the reservoir out with the hose on until you can get it elevated and the fluid away from it. Otherwise, you're going to end up with coolant all over your exhaust. Okay, I'm going to tell you right now, you will have some very pretty language coming out of your mouth if you do it this way. It is a pain in the neck. I recommend using a pneumatic fluid vac, like a Mighty Vac, or a manual fluid transfer pump, which I will use the fluid transfer pump today because it is cheap. It is worth the investment. Get the fluid transfer pump. And we were just going to pump it out. So give me a minute. I'm going to get the pump. I got a link to one of these below. It is very simple contraption. It's just a pump. And we are going to go and pump it from the reservoir into the drain pan. So I'm going to take off the reservoir cap. Just thread it on. And if yours works like mine, the top hose goes into the reservoir. Top hose being the one closest to the handle. Get it down in there. And then you'll put the bottom hose, or have someone hold it if you have a helper. Because if it's coiled up like this, it's a pain. Might be able to find a way to do something like this. And all you do is pump away. Just make sure it's in, down in the reservoir. Get as much out as you can. It does not have to be perfect. If you need it to be perfect, then what I recommend doing is getting some distilled water, pouring it in the reservoir, pump it out, pour some more distilled water in, pump it out. Or remove it, pour it out, and clean it out. But for a simple fluid change, a little residual stuff in there isn't gonna make a difference. So once it's out, go ahead and remove your hoses. Now, if you want to use the pump for filling up the radiator, you're going to want to flush it with some distilled water. But that's all there is for draining the reservoir. Now we are going to go back to where we drained the fluid from. Okay. So again, occasional drip isn't going to be a big deal here. You're going to be putting in way more fluid. It's going to have the lubricative properties. The only reason you'd want to flush this system out is if for some reason, say your water pump went and you have metal shavings, but then you're actually going to flush it. So a little bit of dripping isn't a big deal. You're going to want to remove the crush washer from the drain bolt. Remember, do not reuse them. And do not use just a regular washer. Crush washers are designed to compress and kind of take shape to the surface they're against. They are not, regular washers will not do that. You need to use a crush washer. Now I'm using copper crush washers. I'll have a link to those in the description below. Just put it on the bolt. I would grab a paper towel, just kind of wipe the surface, make sure there's no dirt on there. You're not going to be able to stop the fluid from coming out. Stick the bolt in, thread it in by hand. And once you get it a little snug, the fluid will stop and then you can wipe the area down. Now, what you're going to want to do is get a torque wrench and your 8mm socket. Your torque wrench needs to be 11 Newton meters or 97 inch pounds. And take your torque wrench, tighten it down. It does not need to be super tight. 97 inch pounds is it. Now go ahead and get your Dawn and water mixture. Spray the stuff down that got hit and wipe it down. You know, make sure nothing's on any of your surfaces that you don't want to be slippery, because coolant is slippery. Make sure it'll get behind around everything. And there you go. Now we're ready to fill it back up. Okay, we are back over on the right-hand side of the bike. And now we are going to fill the coolant. Now, you can use a funnel. Just be very careful. Splash out and stuff. It can make a big mess, especially if you drop the funnel. I'm going to use the fluid transfer pump, and the system takes 2.9 US quarts or 2.7 liters. Now that is the full system. You are not going to get the full system because there's still some fluid in there. Unless you actually flush it, there's no way to get it all out. And the reservoir is going to take up some. So I don't expect to fit nearly 3 quarts straight in the radiator. You also need to take your time. As you put fluid in, it needs to work its way down. And this happens by the bubbles coming up and it traveling through the system. Don't expect it to fill up instantly. So you're gonna fill till it comes up into the neck right here, and then wait, and it's gonna drop down. And then you're gonna fill, and then you're gonna wait, and it's gonna drop down. So that's what we're gonna do right now. Biggest problem I'm having right now is keeping the hose in the bottle. So that's why you're seeing tons of air. Anyway, just go slow. Try not to have too much splash out. Matter of fact, I'm gonna go ahead and get some rags. These are just some dirty rags I have. Try not to get any debris in the hole, but dirty rags is fine. Just try and, if you have any overflow or whatnot, you can catch most of it. This isn't like brake fluid. So if you get it on, it's not the end of the world. You don't have to clean it off right away like you do with brake fluid, but it's still easier to just avoid a bigger mess. Anyway, I'm gonna keep pumping. And if you listen carefully, you can tell when it's coming up to the top of the neck. Stop. All right, so we're at the top of the neck. While that soaks down, I'm going to readjust the camera so you can maybe see a little better. So I'll pump some in. And I wasn't paying attention. A little mess, not a big deal. You see how it's up top here? We're going to let it sit here for a little bit. Go clean up, get rid of the old fluid, do whatever. Give it 10 minutes, see what happens, let any bubbles come up. We will return after. Okay, so I cleaned up some of my mess here. That's why this is now folded down. I got some more cleanup to do, but that's fine. We're not done filling yet. Now, this is as far as mine went down, which is fine. Now what you're going to want to do is you can flick the hoses. I find that's never sufficient. You need to get the air out. So what I like to do is squeeze the hoses, and you need to be careful on the initial squeeze because it's going to push fluid up into that neck. You don't want it to overflow. So squeeze the hose and then release. And just do that, work your way on all, any places you can find the hoses, squeeze and release, and that'll help get some of the air out. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. So if you go to the other side of your bike, there's a hose. You wanna squeeze and release it. And as the fluid drops, you're gonna wanna fill it back up because you don't wanna suck more air into the system. That's what you're trying to get out. So we're gonna go, top it off, not too full because we need to be able to squeeze the hose. And this hose on the opposite side of the bike, which you will find down the left side of the radiator. I mean, you can't miss it. And there's also smaller hoses around the oil pump and such. You wanna squeeze them. And basically just keep squeezing all the hoses. Try and get all the air pumped out. This is how you end up with, or how people do their coolant change. And they end up with air bubbles in the pump and their bike overheats. This is just one step of it. So once you do all that, go ahead and get your pump out of here, get out of the way, clean everything up, and we're going to be moving to the reservoir. So see you there. Now I did forget to tell you to put the radiator cap back on. Put the radiator cap back on now, okay? Down here, we're gonna take the reservoir cap off, and you want to find the full line, and that's this line. It's very hard to tell, but it's right up here near the top. And you wanna fill the reservoir to the full line. This is again where the fluid transfer pump will make your life a lot easier. All right, so again, to the full line. Do not overfill this. Be careful taking this hose out. You're probably gonna drip somewhere, some places. It's fine. And what I usually do is I just stick both ends into the jug because we are not done with it. Put the cap back on. So the way a cooling system works is as the bike heats up, as you know, the heat expands. Well, same's with fluid, same's with coolant, it expands. The radiator cap is designed to keep it at a certain pressure so it doesn't turn to steam. Even so, when it gets so hot, it has to expand out. So it ends up going into the reservoir. When the system cools down, it sucks out of the reservoir. So it pulls the fluid back into the cooling system as it cools down. So when you first change out your fluid, you're actually going to be under the amount because there's still air in there. It's gonna work itself out. So what's gonna happen is as you run, this is not actually gonna get any higher when it gets hot, but when it cools down, it's gonna suck it back down to fill up where the air came out. That's why we did not put the jug away. We are gonna sit here and we are going to probably need to top off the reservoir. Unless somehow I got all of the air out of the system, the reservoir will need topped off. So now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to start the bike. Just start it. Make sure everything sounds right. Make sure there's no rough sounds like the water pump is grinding because it doesn't have any lubrication. Just listen. And if everything sounds good, let the bike warm all the way up. When I say warm all the way up, I mean let the fans kick on. Once done, we are going to rev the bike. So burping a cooling system, by general definition, simply means you get the air bubbles out. So that's what we were doing when we were squeezing the hoses and and trying to get all the bubbles out before we started up the bike. Now, another part of the burping process is you run the bike, let it heat all the way up, and then you turn it off and you let it cool all the way down. This gets, of course, the fluids moving and run through the system and gets air to work its way to the top up at the radiator cap. And eventually that gets replaced by sucking into the from the reservoir. So you're supposed to do this multiple times. Sometimes it could take like 5 times to get all the air out of the system. I like adding another step to this, and that is revving the motorcycle during the burping process. That is my definition of burping. When you actually heat it up and then you rev it. What that does is it spins the engine up, which speeds the water pump up, which helps push the air bubbles through the system. And eventually they accumulate to the top of the radiator cap. So that is my burping process. It has worked for me, and usually I only need to do it twice and all the air is out of the system. So that is the process I'm gonna do. That's the process I recommend you do. You do not have to do that, but revving the bike seems to work for me. There's no sense in me recording the bike warming up. So we will return once that happens. Walk around the bike here. And you'll notice the reservoir has not gone up. Okay, the motorcycle is, it was at 212, but my fans kicked on, so it dropped down. And it's gonna go up, fans will kick on, it'll drop back down. Don't mind the blinking temperature gauge. That's going to happen because I don't have my temperature sensor hooked up because I took off the lower fairings. Now, you want to check for leaks. This is important. Go down and check the drain plug. Make sure nothing is coming out. Make sure you have a good seal. You want to check the hoses. Make sure they're in good condition. Be very, very careful if you're checking anything around here because that is extremely hot. One of the reasons these bikes run hot is because it's right next to the header. Check all your hoses down here. These are all cooling hoses. Check them all, make sure they're in good condition. As I said, most of them I could not get. They are backordered. So once you check all the left-hand side here, this is the hose that I was squeezing to get air bubbles out on the left side. Once you check this side, go ahead and check the radiator cap. Make sure there's no leaks. So the fan has been kicking on and kicking off, which is what we want. Dropping the temp down to 204, and it'll creep back up and the fan will come on. So we are at temperature. Now we're gonna do my method of fully burping the system, and that involves twisting the throttle. All you're doing is revving the bike up slightly. You're not going over 6,000 RPM here. Just repeat. Give it a couple surges of water pressure through the cooling system. This will help push the bubbles out. Now give it a minute and do the same thing again. All right, and that should get all the air out. And you can check your reservoir. And you'll notice it's still right at full because it did not have extra fluid in it. Turn the bike off, okay? Now you are going to let the bike sit and cool all the way down. So that's gonna take a while. If you need to do an oil change, go ahead and do your oil change. That's actually what I'm gonna do right now. But you need to let it cool all of the way down. And we will return when that happens. So the bike has cooled down, and you will notice that the reservoir has actually dropped down below the full mark. This is because as the system cooled down, it pulled in fluid to take the place of the air that we worked out of the system. So now we want to top off the reservoir so it is full again. Now you can choose to top this off now, or you can wait until you go through another cycle of warming it up, revving the bike, letting it cool down. But topping it off, same exact thing as filling it up originally. Just put the fluid in. Remember to not overfill it, because if it heats up and it's too full, it's going to overflow. So this won't take much. Okay, put the cap back on. Now that we've done that, you're going to do the process again. You're going to fire the bike up. You're going to let it warm all the way up. You're going to rev it. At least if you want to do my method, you'll hit the throttle a couple times and then do the same thing. Check the reservoir. Make sure it's at the full mark. Repeat until it's always full. Once it's always full in the reservoir, that means your system is completely full and the air should all be worked out. Then you can go ahead, put your motorcycle back together, and you're done. That's all there is to the fluid change. I know there's a lot of steps involved, but it's a pretty simple process. Now, again, I do apologize for not being able to do the full cooling system, the hoses, the gaskets, the O-rings, because you have to take out the water pump and the oil cooler and everything to replace everything. And I apologize that I cannot do that. But without being able to get the parts in, I can't show you that without risking damage to the gaskets and O-rings and such to where I would be stuck without my motorcycle. So once all the parts come in, I will do a video showing you how to do everything. Until then, I just can't. So right now, this is just a coolant change. The most important thing is to check all your hoses, make sure there's no cracks and that they look like they're in good condition. If you want to replace the radiator cap, I mean, that's pretty easy. Just switch out the radiator cap. And if you want to replace the thermostat, that's a little trickier because it's down and back out of the way. So can't just show you from here. When I do the full video, we will replace that. But otherwise, I'm sorry, this is about all I can do right now for you. But that does get the most important piece, which is getting fresh coolant in there, which will be able to keep your water pump lubricated and all the components functioning the way they should. Thanks for watching. Ride safe. Keep the rubber side down. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I will try and answer everyone's questions as soon as possible. If there's anything you'd like to see, any tips, tricks, techniques, anything at all motorcycle related, please let me know. I do these videos for you, so anything that you would like to see, I am more than happy to do it. If you like this video, please click that thumbs up button. And if you haven't already, please subscribe and click the bell to notify you whenever a new video drops. Thank you again. Ride safe and keep the rubber side down.